I had told you earlier that in case of an option, the loss of the holder of an option is always limited, and it is limited to the extent of the amount of premium that he has paid. So when the in the case that we are discussing right now, and which is on your screen, when the current price is 180, is he going to exercise the option? All of you?
No, sir.
He is not going to exercise the option. Obviously, he is not going to exercise the option. Because since he is not going to exercise the option, is he really going to incur a loss? The answer is he is not going to exercise the option, and therefore he is not going to incur a loss. It is only for our understanding that we have to be clear that the moment the current selling price goes beyond the strike price, the option becomes out of money. And when it becomes out of money, it also means it is not to be exercised. So this is, friends, what you have to remember. So I would like Kamal also to give me the answer. Kamal or Sanjay or anybody else for that matter. What will be your answer in this case, all of you?
Yeah, sir, in 140, 150, 160, mm-hmm. It is in the money.
Okay.
And 170 is at the money. Okay. 180, 90, 200,
out of the money. Very good. And what are his gains and losses, Ankit, for all these eight situations?
Yes, sir. Less the premium, sir, for the net profit and the loss, sir.
Mm, so how much will it be?
Yeah.
How much will it
sir,
be?
In the 180, 30 minus 10 means 20 rupees is the net profit.
When?
At 140.
At 140.
And 10 rupees is the profit. 10 rupees at the 150,
uh-huh.
And zero at 160,
uh-huh.
Means 170 loss of 10 rupees,
okay.
Loss of 20 at 180, loss of 30, loss of 40, and loss of 50.
Yes, Devang, you want to say something?
At 120.
Over 180, then loss over 190. He won't exercise the option, only
10
rupees is the loss.
Right.
After money, he won't exercise the option. The loss is maximum
10
bucks.
Correct. Okay. Very good. Very good. Very good. So let's see it here. In the situation, so the profit is going to be 20. I think Ankit, you have mentioned it very correctly, and Devang, you also has mentioned it very correctly. Because the loss is going to be maximum 10, because when the option is out of money, obviously you will not exercise it. So if you will not exercise, that means you will not suffer that difference, and therefore your loss is going to be limited only to the extent of the premium that you have paid. And as regards the in the money, at the money, and out of money, as we have discussed, so this is how it is. It is going to be, so when it is 140, 150, 160, it is in the money. At 170, it is at the money, and beyond 170, it becomes out of money. So friends, this is the concept of in the money, at the money, and out of money. So how do we understand this? So when the current market price is less than the strike price, it is in the money. Current market price is equal to the strike price, it is at the money. And current market price is higher than the strike price, it is out of the money. And this is in the context of the put option. When you look at in terms of the call option, it will be the other way around. And that is what you should remember.